குரும் விக்னேஸ்வரம் ருத்ரம் சந்திரசேகரமவ்யஜம் வந்தேஹம் பவதாபக்னம் பவம் கௌரீபதிம் சிவம்.
வி சா சாத்தியம் சிவபத பிராப்தி சாதனம் தஸ்ய சேவனம். த கோல் இஸ் சிவபத அண்ட் த பாத் இஸ் ஹிஸ் சேவனம், ஹிஸ் சர்வீஸ். திஸ் இட் செல்ஃப் இஸ் உபாசனா. டு சர்வ் ஹிம் இட் செல்ஃப் இஸ் ஹிஸ் உபாசனா. The servant always moves around his Swami, waiting for his call. He never moves away from his Swami. Upasana has many synonyms. Seva, Paricharya, Shushrusha, they are all synonyms of Upasana. So Upasana is not sitting in Padmasana, wearing Rudraksha, pretending to be a Tapasvi. That is not Upasana. Upasana is serving him as a servant. The essence is to be with him always. Physically, mentally, always. To be with him mentally always is very important. You may be living in Kashi or even in a Shiva temple, but if your mind is not with him, in him, then it is not Upasana. You may be doing Shivalinga Puja every day, but at that time, if your mind is engrossed in your day-to-day problems, your promotion, your children's education, your wife's health, then that is not Upasana. You are not mentally with him then. Mind has to be with him. We saw in Chanchula's case, her mind filled with the Lord. He filled her mind. That is how she attained Shivaloka.
Pratyaksham chakshusha drishtva tatra lokah pravartate.
Whatever is visible, there is a method to get it. That is common knowledge. That is doable. You see a photograph of some place, say Mansarovar, you want to go there, that is your destination, your goal. There is a way to do that. Get visa, book tickets, pack your bag and go. You know where to go and what to do for that. But what if it is apratyaksha, not visible? You can't go there. You don't know where to go, how to go there. The only way is to bring that to you. This is in a way easier because you can do that sitting where you are. You don't have to apply for permission, visa, book tickets and go. You can get it sitting where you are. But then, how do you do that? Whatever you are trying to bring to you, where do you keep it? You have to keep it in your mind only. For that, you have to get that into your mind first. You can't go to Mahadeva because you don't know where he is. You can bring him to your mind. You can get him to your mind. You have to provide him space in your mind and he will soon fill your mind. How do you get him to your mind? The doors to your mind are five, the five sensory organs: ears, eyes, nose, tongue and skin. You can access your mind only through these five doors. So the Lord has to enter your mind through one of these doors or all of these doors. When you see a Shivalinga or an image of Lord Shiva, that enters your mind. But it may not make any sense. You show a Shivalinga to a Russian or an Irish villager, he may not even recognize it as Shivalinga. For him, it may look like just a sculpted piece of rock. We know it as Shivalinga because we have heard about it. Only if you have heard about it, the image conveys any meaning. So the primary source of jnana is hearing or words. Words as written in a book and entering the mind through the eyes is also good enough. Primary source of knowledge is words of description that enter as sound through the ears or as material read of a book. So for being an upasaka of Mahadeva, you have to first hear about him. What he is like, what he does, his greatness, this is how he enters into your mind. Never miss an opportunity to hear his greatness. Make conscious effort to hear his greatness.
Apratyaksham hi sarvatra jnatva shrotrena cheshtate tasma chravanamadau shrutva gurumukhat budhah.
Upasana has three parts: shrotrena shravanam, tasya vachasa kirtanam, tatha manasa mananam tasya mahasadhanam uchyate. Once shravana happens, then there is Kirtana and Manana. These two are natural. Kirtana means you yourself will start speaking about His glory. This is spontaneous. This is natural. But this is something unique. If you know something about Him, then you will spontaneously feel like sharing it with others. It is very difficult to hold yourself from doing this. You may not be facing an audience and giving a discourse, but you will do this in your own way, among your friends, your relatives. This is Kirtana. Hearing is Shravana and telling it to others is Kirtana. Every time you do Kirtana, every time you share, talk about His glory to others, you are strengthening the Lord's presence inside. His presence inside your mind increases every time you talk about Him to others. So if you are an Upasaka, don't be silent. Speak about Him. Every time you get an opportunity, speak about Him. This is for your own benefit. It will benefit you more than it benefits others. And as you go on hearing and talking about Him more and more, manana, meditation, reflecting upon Him internally starts happening more and more. After Shravana, Kirtana and Manana are natural. Tatas samsadhaye danyat kirtanam mananam sudhihi. It says, samsadhayet, showing effort from your side. But soon you will realize that it has become spontaneous, natural to you. So start with Shravana. Then Kirtana and Manana will happen on their own. This is the threefold upasana of Mahadeva. Shravana, Kirtana, Manana. Shivaya Namaha.
Yajna Hishre Kadaman Karma.